So, I received a text message this morning when I was sleeping, and I didn't get the text message until about 5:30 a.m. And today's gig log might be a little flat. It may be a little off, but I received a text message this morning that my oldest niece was in a car accident and she was taken to the ICU. Non-responsive. So I just got off the phone with her mom and she's in the ICU at the hospital and I'm gonna attempt to go see her in a little while. The good news is that she's stable and there's no bleeding inside or anything like that. So thankful for that. But getting that text message this morning and the call has really shocked me today. And I have a wedding I have to do today. So I wanted to go ahead and let everybody know on this video. It might be a little bit different today. Because, I or we face a lot of challenges whenever we do events, especially weddings. And today is going to be a different kind of challenge for me. So it's going to be tough, it's going to be different, and I'm going to have to push through it. But I wish my niece the best of luck. I'm hoping to see her. I love her very much. So today is going to be very, very, very challenging. And I just wanted to start out letting you guys know it might be off. There might be something bothering me. And if you are wondering why, that is why. Tough day ahead.
You're in the mix with the one and only DJ A Valley from Total Events DJ Service Maine.
To get dressed. A nice bathroom for once. Trash. One of the bridesmaids is taking me to the ceremony site, which is about a quarter mile from the venue. And I have a battery-powered speaker today, thanks to my friend Nixon. And that's the way we're gonna do it. See how far we gotta go here. I'm ready to go. Setup is all set at the venue. Now just going to the site to get my speaker. I have my songs ready for the ceremony. And ceremony starts in 35 minutes. So everything's going as planned. I had to bust my ass on my setup today. So I'm walking down to where the ceremony is going to be. We're right out in the woods, the beautiful Maine woods. And
starting to cool off. It was a little muggy earlier. Starting to cool off. It's good. We're right next to the ocean, so good ocean breeze coming up now. But I'm walking to the ceremony spot, and I'm going to provide a speaker for them today. Battery-powered speaker. She wants 3 songs, and I'm going to get them on there for her. And I want to show you guys where I'm going to be at. They picked a beautiful spot. I can't wait. It's going to be nice. It's going to work out great. So once I get there, I'll show you the spot. Pretty sweet. So they wanted to do it by the pond. Beautiful location. I love it. It's fantastic. Check this out. Beautiful spot. Gotta get my speaker out here, do the ceremony, and then back to the venue. This is the battery-powered speaker that I'm using today. It's a Rockville 15-inch battery-powered speaker. Everything on the back. Multiple kinds of inputs. USB, Bluetooth, SD card, XLR, quarter-inch, RCA. And obviously, if you want to use the radio, you have your antenna stuff. But comes with a couple of mics. Rockville 15-inch battery-powered speaker. Gonna work perfect for today. Now that's an anthill, bub. People are arriving 15 minutes before ceremony. They should be coming, get ready to line up for the ceremony. And I have a nice little spot, kind of hid the speaker behind everybody. And wow, I tried the Bluetooth out on that speaker with my phone just to see how far and what range it had. And I walked like 50 feet and it was still connected. And I turned around. Great connectivity. So Rockville guys, check them out. I'm up here in the woods and no one can see me, nobody can hear me, but fun, awesome thing for today. The walkout song that Emily just came down the aisle to was her friend Whitney singing a song, and Whitney since has passed. And so she walked down the aisle and that song that Whitney sung in a wedding was my wedding that I did 3 years ago, and she was right next to me. Cool little twist and pretty awesome. So that's why I love to do weddings and events, stuff like that. You can't beat it.
This is my solemn vow to you. Before God.
Ceremony is done. Went perfectly. That, you know, this Rockville battery powered speaker is really good, guys. Wow. Like, you could probably get 100 feet Bluetooth connectivity with it. And it, the sound was great. And it played for over 30 minutes. And it's not dead or anything, so it worked out perfectly. I hit it in the bushes, and, you know, it did what it needed to do. So thanks, Nixon, for letting me use your speaker. I gotta buy one of these things. But anyways, heading back to the venue. We're going to rock the house. It's going to be a great night. Keg, open bar, and all. Stay tuned. Now we're back at the venue. This is the outside. I'm going to play some cornhole. Beautiful spot. They have me right here inside. Bridal party will be here in about 30 minutes. Get ready for introductions and stuff. Hors d'oeuvres, everybody getting drinks. But I wanted to show you guys. They originally wanted to put me up there. Yeah. Up in the balcony. I gracefully declined.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the newlyweds, let's hear it for Mr. and Mrs. They're going to have their first dance.
Lady right there, that one right there is pissed off. I skipped her table when I was dismissing tables. She got to give it to me, Bob, I'm telling you.
I'd say the staff, there's not too many, but thank you. I'd say the bartender, but we're kind of our own bartender, so thank you everybody for saying that.
Thanks, Ashton.
No, it was amazing.
Well, there you have it, guys. Gig log over. It is the next day, Sunday, and I ended last night at 10 p.m. and got home before midnight. So that was a plus. It's always nice to go ahead and get home at a reasonable hour so you can get some sleep and you're not dead the next day. Couple things about the gig. Great crowd, everybody was responsive. I didn't get a lot of dancing time. I only had about an hour to crank it up and get everybody dancing because there was one thing that happened. The photographer took the bride and groom away from me at 7:30 p.m. for another half hour. She had to do the twilight session for pictures, and I knew automatically what that would do to my crowd and to the atmosphere of the gig, of the ceremony, of the celebration. People started to leave and they started to get bored, so I did my best to try to keep everyone there, but it's very hard when you're gonna go and do some more fun events with the bride and groom and then the photographer takes them from you. So I was very irritated with that. I tried to persuade it in a different way, but it didn't work out for me. So, what can I say? Also, I think a lot of you are wondering about my niece, Madison. And I have great news. She's stable. And she has gone home with no significant damages, only a couple things in her back. So I'm very blessed and very thankful that she's okay. It bothered me all day, and it is a sigh of relief that I know she's going to be okay. But that's the way it goes, guys. I'll show you guys a picture of the car, and thank you guys. Hope to see you guys again on my next video. There'll be another video coming very soon. I hope you liked the video. Please like and subscribe. My name is DJ Valley. Till the next time, guys. Peace.